I'm so happy to get out of the pearl set and the sweater set and the palms. I'm ready to have a good time tonight.
Yes.
So I'm happy to be here for so many reasons, because as was stated, I would not be here if not for the work of Rush and if not for the work of Danny Simmons. And when people talk about Brooklyn is the hottest new place in the world, it's the hottest this or the coolest borough on the planet, that's because individuals like Danny Simmons were here putting Brooklyn on the map in a major way and developing a thriving arts community that has gathered all of us here today. This is the Village of Brooklyn, New York. And it's because of your creativity, your talent, your ambition, and all the hard work that everyone has put in here. We have put the flavor in Brooklyn, New York, that everybody's coming from all over the world to savor. Right? So I want to thank Danny, because 15 years ago, maybe longer now, I was at a bus stop and ran into Danny, and I was like, I'm trying to start a museum, and I want you to be on my board. And he said, let's do it. And almost now, going on 17 years later, in 2018, Mokata will move into a $12 million state-of-the-art building. And that's why the work of Rush is important, to give people an opportunity for their dreams and their aspirations to come true. This is a platform for us, and we need to continue to feed it. So the work that you see here, make sure everybody goes home with something. Because it's fundraisers like that that allowed me to be where I am today. And when I came to Danny and I said, I want to run for city council, he said, I got you. Let's put a movement together and bring the first elected official from an arts background into the city council. And I just want to tell you one thing about that, right? I know everybody, the drinks are flowing and everybody looks good. They want to hook up, meet up, so I'm not going to take up too much. Because I know this is where y'all meet up at, and I don't blame you, everybody looks good here tonight. One of the pieces of legislation that we're moving towards is all of the affordable housing. I'm looking to pass legislation that will make it so that artists have a priority in the affordable housing that's coming to New York City. That's one. The second one, I'll be looking to pass legislation this year talking about, we want to see the diversity of all of New York City's organizations. Who's on your board of trustees? Who's on your staff? Who are the artists that you are representing? And every year we're going to look at that to see if these institutions where we put our taxpaying dollars are hiring people from our community. And an initiative, lastly, that I was able to pass in the city council that will roll out this year, I was able to secure $720,000 for an anti-gun violence initiative based in the arts.
Right.
Because for too long, the arts have not been a part of the toolkit to solving solutions based on gun violence in our communities. But that's going to be changing. So in me, you have a champion that's going to be working to make sure that the arts are a part of every conversation made in New York City.
Yes.
So no one there, no, I love you. I love all of our honorees. We've had such a privilege of working all together. Renee has exhibited at the museum. Victor and I have partnered together. And I'm just meeting Ricky and Dee, who are fantastic, representing holding down Staten Island.
Woo!
Are recognized and are global. So thank you all.